Hi YouTube, it's Monique's Journey. Little bit of music. So it is, oh my gosh, I don't know what week it is. Hang on. Let me check. Okay. So today is September 19th, 2014, Friday, and this is my week 19 update. And I am coming to you from my home. Last week I did not do an update. I fully intended, but I went cottaging. Things didn't line up very well, so I did not do a video, and a whole bunch of things kind of slid off the rails, but we'll get to that. So let's start with the numbers, and maybe you'll understand what the whole song's about. So 2 weeks ago, I was at 181.9. My starting weight was 218. Last week, I didn't do a video, but I still recorded my weight. I was at 179.5. And this week, I am at 178.5. So, let's go with ABBA, 178.5, 70s. I'm in the 70s. And not only am I in the 70s, but I was in the 70s for like 2 weeks. So, that puts my total loss at 39.5 pounds. So, I am this close to being 40 pounds down. 40 freaking pounds, people. 40! Okay. I was looking back and I can't remember the last time I was in the 170s. It could have been possibly like 2002, 2003. I'd have to look at some of my data from before because I did lose a whole mess of weight. So I may have hit the 170s back in 2001. So there you go. That tells you how long it's been. So how does that feel? It feels fan-freaking-tastic. Yes, people are noticing my boss is kind of starting to get a little, you know, how much more weight are you planning to lose kind of feeling. Now, she's coming from a good place. She's super fit. You know, she's a life coach and super fitness buff. She's really, you know, tight and firm and lean, that kind of thing. And, you know, she told me she would love to have thinner legs, but she also wants to be healthy. So her concern for me was about being healthy. So, yeah. So I tried on my size 8 jeans a couple weeks ago. They still don't fit, but they're getting close. I can get them up past my butt, and there's about yay much to button them. And okay, I can button them. Let's be honest, I can button them if I suck it in. But then I couldn't unbutton them. That was pretty scary. So like, oh crap, I'm gonna have to get cut out of these jeans because I couldn't suck it in enough to get them unbuttoned. Anyways, so I'm gonna keep trying. I'm gonna keep working at it. But last weekend, a whole bunch of things derailed for me. Things at home have been a little bit tenuous. As those who know, when you invest yourself in a community and invest yourself in weight loss and in fitness and all these commitments that weren't part of my life before, plus a new job, it's been a balancing act. And my partner, bless him, he's really sweet. He's definitely feeling a little neglected. So I've made some changes. One of them is I am not aiming for 10,000 steps a day. Now, he's pushing me to do it, but frankly, it was driving some really bad behaviors on my part where I would just come home and be like, oh, okay, I can't talk to you right now. I got to walk. And that's just not quite where I want us, you know, where I want to end up. I want this to be a life habit. So I've switched that goal from 10,000 steps a day to an hour of some kind of fitness with my partner and my dog. So fitness and walking, basically. So my goal right now is to try to do an hour's worth of walking or something along those lines with my partner. We're not getting to it every day, but we're committed to do it. So that might be a good change. The challenge is that it's not as easy to track as 10,000 steps on my Fitbit. Let's be honest. The Fitbit was what keeps me really honest, or kept me really on track. So that thing number two that didn't happen was running. So it rained most of the time that we were there, and when it stopped raining, it was just absolutely god awfully wet and gross. And I couldn't go running, or I chose not to go running. I also didn't run anytime this week. But I am going to run tomorrow morning. So that's it. Tomorrow's Saturday. I'm going to get up. I'm going to put my dang shoes on. And even if it's cold out or it's rainy, and running at home is not such a big deal in the rain because we have sidewalks and I have these paved trails. But we were out in cottage country where, you know, frankly, some of the mud puddles were almost knee deep. So I didn't want to get stuck somewhere that I didn't know without a support system out in the middle of God's country, because it takes, you know, a good 10-minute walk to get from house to house. So I didn't want to get stranded while I was running. But tomorrow I'll be able to run from home. So that is good. Food-wise, I've been doing okay. Although, again, while I was cottaging, I had a pumpkin spice muffin on my way to the cottage, and I had a pumpkin spice muffin on my way home. So yeah, so two muffins. They were really delicious, and frankly I really want more, but I have stopped it at two and I'm going to keep there. So that's that's pretty much what's been happening here. So this week I'm committing to I'm gonna run three times. One, two, three, and I will video all three times. So if you do not see a post-run video on my channel, give me crap. Yeah, I'm going to hold myself accountable, but yeah, I love your feedback and stuff. Thing two is I'm going to aim towards getting my water in. So I haven't been doing a very good job of getting my water. And then thing three, that the third commitment this week is to put stuff in my Fitness Pal. So there has been no food logging for this girl in a while. So I need to bring that back. So that's those are the habits that I know get me to where I want to go. And I have thirty point five pounds to go before I hit my target. So if I really want to do this, if I really want to get to that milestone, I gotta kick it into gear. I am investigating gyms. By investigating, I mean right now it's just looking at them online. Next step will be to get some actual passes to go check these places out. Gyms intimidate me. I just don't know. I know that it gets cold and wet and snowy down here. Last year we had like 6 feet of snow, so running outside is not going to be possible. So I do need to suck it up and go to a gym. But I'm just trying to figure out the balance. Do I want a gym that has all the fitness classes and the fanciness and such, or do I just want the straight, you know, treadmill, weights, blah 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 gym? Like, you know, so do I want luxury gym, or do I want bargain basement gym, or is there somewhere in between, or is there a combination? I don't know. So if you've got any suggestions on what works for you and how you get over that intimidation factor, give me a little comment. I'd love to hear it. So yeah, that's about all I'm going to have for this week. So, don't forget to be as kind to yourself as you are to everyone else, and just enjoy life. Have a great one. Bye.